Sometimes people say, don't overspeed or you'll crash. But in Boston Back Bay, 29 years ago, today, was one of the worst train wrecks on the Northeast Corridor. Hey!
When I'm alone, I'd rather be with you. Fuck these other niggas, I'll be right by your side till 2005.
On December 11th, 1990, Amtrak train number 66, the Night Owl, departed Washington, D.C. for Boston, Massachusetts. The train was hauled by two F-40 PHs, 272 and 366. The train was carrying two material handling cars, two baggage cars, three Amfleet Phase 3, one Heritage Diner, and two sleepers, 190 passengers and seven crew members. The drivers of the train were Willis E. Copeland and driver Ann Bramson. They were both acquainted for 15 years. And the train departed
Route 128 station, bound for Boston South. Meanwhile, MBTA 906 was being pushed by MBTA F40PH 1073.
Five coach cars and one cab car. And the train departed Ruggles, headed for the same direction to Boston South. And it got on that station, and then it went back out and did the Boston Back Bay Tunnel. Driver Ed Bramson was running Amtrak 66 and was going 100 miles an hour.
The train was making its way through that tunnel and saw the MBTA train. The train pulled on the emergency brakes, and the speed was 106 miles an hour to 78 miles an hour, and as a result, the train derails and crashes into the MBTA 906 at Boston Back Bay Tunnel.
No casualties occurred, but 453 people were sustained injuries.
MBTA F40PH 1073 was destroyed. 272 was lightly damaged, however, 366 was crumbled into a ball.
And the MBTA's first coach was destroyed.
The map shows what the collision looked like. This cause of the crash was overspeeding. Here's a picture of the actual tunnel's damage.
The train was supposed to travel at 78 miles an hour, or 20 miles an hour, but had to speed up because it was late. After the accident,
Amtrak fired both drivers for the accident.
And the accident was the finger at them. And they were also banned from railroading.
The MBTA 40PH was almost literally destroyed. 366 was deemed a total loss and scrapped. It's been 29 years since this crash, and accidents still occur on the Northeast Corridor today.